And I love you on One Day at a Time.
Oh my gosh.
I need to know about season 3 on that one.
Ooh, I don't know that I can give anything away. I mean, it's all been pretty hush-hush. I don't really know what's going to go down, but it was such a blast working on season 2. And I mean, everyone's so great to work with. And just, I loved it. I mean, it was really great.
Are your characters still together at least?
Oh, I guess we'll just have to see. I mean, I know it was really great working with Isabella, and you know, my favorite moment was doing the whole promposal. I mean, that's, how can you not have fun doing that? So it was a great time, and everyone there is so amazing. I mean, Rita Moreno, that was like starstruck, but she's so nice. Like, she just comes up to you and gives you a hug at the beginning of the day, and you're like, what did I do to deserve this? You know, it was just like, love it. Yeah,
I see you're still within the Netflix family, and you have a guest star role at Dear White People. Can you tell me about your character this season?
Yeah, so I was really excited that Abigail came back this season. You know,
we thought she was gone.
Oh yeah, yeah, it seemed that way. She literally got kicked out of a radio booth last season, so I was like, oh man, that was pretty rough for her. She always seems to find a way to stick her foot in her mouth, or just, I mean, she's a sweet girl who means well, but she's very fun to play. It's such a funny, like, the way they write the character is so funny. So I mean, whenever I get the scripts, I was like, that's hilarious. And I mean, I'm just so grateful to Justin and everyone at Dear White People for bringing me back, because I just had the best time with it. Yeah.
Well, will we see your character go through a change since she went through so much in the first season, like, and she left the radio booth, and like, she goes through so much, will we see her kind of be more, well, maybe less ignorant?
Well, you're just going to have to see what happens with that. You will be entertained. She and Coco, I will say, have some great moments that are really funny that you're going to have to watch out for. So, yeah.
Any secrets from season 3 of One Day at a Time?
I don't think I can. I have any secrets that I can divulge at this moment. But you know what? We're just going to have to stay posted on that, because I'm super excited to see what happens. And you know, it's really like, I feel so lucky to be on 2 shows that are just so hilarious, and Netflix has been great. So yeah.
Well, you're on 2 shows that are culturally like important.
Yeah.
You know, one Cuban American family, and another with Dear White People, with the Black community. So how does it feel to be part of both, like, 2 important shows?
You know, it's funny because I feel like with Sid on One Day at a Time, you know, Sid is a non-binary character, and they're so important to so many people. The messages that I've got just from playing the character, I mean, I couldn't have anticipated just the nice things that people were saying, and how they've never seen themselves represented on screen in that way. I'm like, you know, that's, I can't even describe, like, how grateful I am to all the fans. It's been incredible. And it's funny just because, like, Abigail, I think, is such a different character from that. So it's been fun to be able to play 2 characters who are both really funny. Like, say I mean, Abigail says some crazy stuff that's pretty funny. I don't know that she realizes that it's funny, but to the audience, you know, she's like, it's like, oh, Abigail, okay. And then, you know, Sid is just a sweetie. Like, to me, I'm like, oh, I love Sid. So it's been just amazing. Yeah.
Thank you so much. I'm excited to see both.